5 seconds remaining.
Alright, so they will pick up Undying. That'll just, it's just another thing maybe to counter out the eventual late game that'll come from Shadow Demon Luna. Just a lot of teamfight capability. But,
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah. They will go ahead and wheel to take up their last pick here. They do have the most reserve time available, whereas last game they panic picked PA and the Dragonite. The Dragonite was okay, but I don't think the PA was going to be very beneficial.
Disruptor!
And they will take up the Disruptor, so Team Freedom are making sure, or not Team Freedom, Wheel are trying to make sure that Disruptor is not going to end up getting Team Freedom's pretty core heroes here. Disruptor, one of the better ones that Team Freedom is usually using, but it looks like Wheel Whreck will take it themselves here. Just a lot of things to pair up with the possible team fight engagement, the Luna SD combo, Nyx Assassins just annoying in general. So of course, looks like Wheel Whreck, they still need to search for their last core, and Team Freedom will take up Batrider as their offlane, and they will search for their last core. And Wheel, they will search for their last ban here. I kind of do like Team Freedom's lineup here, but I said that about the last one, and it looked 50-50 when it came to the other thing. Maybe this will be the new Ember Spirit build coming out, which will be the mostly magic damage one. And, I mean, obviously it's Shadow Demon Luna, so there's nothing really to really predict with that one. Lifestealer will be the other ban here from Wheel. So it looks like, I mean, it's still fairly colorful lineup on the side of Team Freedom. I don't think Lifestealer was the main plan, but I think it was still a possibility that Team Freedom can end up picking up the Lifestealer. Viper could have also been a very good lineup here as well, but banned out by themselves, Viper is no longer in the pool. So we are waiting to figure out Team Freedom's last ban and Team Freedom's core pick. Now it looks like it's Team Freedom that's running up the clocks here with their reserve time. Ban out the jug.
Team pick.
Whoa, what?
Radiant team pick.
Whoa, hang on here. Illusion battle versus illusion battle. Spectre in the game. This is a hero I have not seen in a while, and I'm very ecstatic to see in a pro game, and especially by the one and only Team Freedom.
10 seconds.
So Spectre will be the pickup here, the last core for Team Freedom. Not an anti mage, not a anything else like that. Team Freedom will pick up Spectre.
Reserve time.
So this will be fairly interesting. Wheel, they have a minute to figure out what they want to do here. But I mean, even I don't know how to answer this Spectre. Oh, that actually is a perfect answer. They will take up the Razor instead. So Wheel Whreck, not really running a lot in the durability lineup here. Of course, the Luna will build probably into durability items in the future, but this is a Undying Abaddon support, Batrider in the off, Ember Spirit safe, and Ember mid, and then Spectre in the safe. Or in the new safe, who knows? They're just going through their strategy time here, so Team Freedom and Wheel Whreck will figure out where they want to do and all that crazy stuff going on there. So this will be the name of the game. It's the Spectre versus Razor battle. Spectre not really seen that often anymore, but often enough, I guess, for Team Freedom to pick them up here in this lineup. I have a zoom in. Okay. All right. So as always, we will start over on the side of the Radiant. We have Wheel. It's a bug every game, huh? You're a bug. Oh man, that's funny. Anyway. Oh, that's true. 2017 is a bug. Anyway, Shadow Demon is going to be the first pickup here by... Oh my god, what am I doing? Shadow Demon will be played by Derp Derp. Luna will be played by Complete Retard. Disruptor by Layala. Disruptor, the other lightning creature, Razor, is going to be played by Ifrit. 2017 will be on Nyx Assassin. Meanwhile, on the side of the Dire, we have Team Freedom Eagle. It's going to be playing Undying. Spectre will be played by BSJ. Abaddon on Jubai. Batrider is going to be the one and only Mike. And Ember Spirit will be Nora, which I have been told is somebody else, but I can't remember the name, so I'll worry about that later. So it looks like everyone's getting out here. The smokes were deployed early to get everyone out to the runes early, but now the smokes will have expired. Place his aggressive lane ward. Does that ward out? No, it doesn't ward out any camps. So Complete Retard will be scouted out by that. Do not see these rotations. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Looks like there will be no fighting over the runes this time. It will be a 2-2 even trade runes, as Nora will just freely spin around the rune spot there. Ifrit to scout to see if anyone's going to be taking it, but looks like the rune will go to Ifrit. The Rune Scoop is a great conductor. Looks like Eagle will end up getting a double steal in this bot here. Oh, it's Tomato. Got it. Tomato is the other one. So Tomato is actually... crap. Where is he? Tomato is Eagle. Speaking of which, Eagle getting jumped on in the bottom here. He is going to be chopped up in this disruption field. There is no moonbeam from Complete Retard just yet. Eagle is going to be able to escape. No, he won't. That's another disruption field. One more right click. Oh no, he does end up getting the steal. Eagle, though, he loses the initial. And he will end up going down Layala. I saw that in the forecast. Layala will end up getting that there. A gift from the Tiamat of Flash. Runes will go out. Again, sorry for the overlay. Not used to using overlays. Anyway, Looks like this bot lane is going to be the main target here. Actually, it looks like there's some aggression going out top. No, not really. Dubai just sapping experience from that pull there. He's going to have a really hard time in this lane, I guess. I didn't really think there was going to be a hard time here. BSJ actually looking for Desolate, so he wants to go for solo lane damage here. It's not going to be the Desolator. It's the first lineup here, though. Not a Deso. Man, whatever. Looks like IX Mike, he's actually going to get disrupted up here. Derp, derp. They're applying the extra damage, though. Does that? Firefly does not work, actually, but he will be able to get out just maybe. He's trying to go back in on these illusions for some reason. Maybe they want to try and prevent that pull, or they want that big creep. Is somebody low? I mean, what's with this diving coming out from Mike here? And it looks like that will actually just go to complete retard here. Yes. So, motto, the mid player. So wait, Jubai is the, I don't know. I'm going to leave it as is. Derp, derp. We'll finally get Eagle again, complete retard. Maybe to dive IX Mike here, but not going to happen. 2017 trying to find BSJ. Level 3 in the stun already. Level 5 at 4 minutes. 22 and 2, actually. Wheel having a pretty good time in this offlane. They're leading in the CS, and they're leading in the kills. They weren't leading in the CS last game, but they were leading in kills in the early last game. So not really too much else going on. It's fairly difficult. 2017 having a freedom sort of Nyx assassin. Ifrit though, he is gonna get the dive on the Eagle. Is he gonna find Nora though? Nora's gonna find Ifrit instead. Is the damage gonna be there though? There's so much right click damage from Ifrit. One more hit would have actually killed him there. So Nora will end up getting that kill indefinitely. Looks like it is going to be another engagement going on here. Complete retard, taking a little bit of damage from Mike, but got a lot of HP, which is actually very surprising on level 5 Luna. Maybe she has like really good strength gain. I don't know. BSJ is going to end up popping out this shrine. The mana, do the thing to confirm here. Nora not to confirm that mana, but it looks like a smoke is going out here. 2017 to try and get an aggressive kill. They don't find Nora immediately. 2017 though, he's right on top of him. Stun, will it be there? The damage buff's going down, the stun to fall as well, but the magic immunity is going to be there. Nora takes no damage from this whole entire fight, actually, and it's totally fine. He did lose mana, though, but that's the only thing that he really lost. Bay, though, he is going to find Derp Derp, but the damage is going to be there from Razor. The sapping is happening. Like a lot of different things going on here. 2017, Invis, TPing down to the bottom. Already activated. They want to jump on Mike here. Will they have the time, though? They need the mana. They actually consume the mango. Mike definitely going down here. Complete retard to confirm the right click for that kill. And this will be the Ember Spirit, the new Ember Spirit build, going for pure magic damage and the Eternal Searing Chains at level 25, plus the Octarine. So, fairly interesting to see how that goes. All the items to build up into that Octarine is the plan here. So, it's going to be fairly interesting to see how this team reacts. It's 4-1. They finally have a kill on the board, but wasn't really that great of a kill and what they had to sacrifice for it. Not exactly the greatest either. Luna's CS in this offlane / safe lane. She's not really doing too well. He's 30-7. Kind of somewhat contested from Mike here, but not too much. So, he does have a wand. It's up to 10 charges already. So, the denies are going to be there, though. 2017 back at it again. He wants to get a jump on Mike. There is no sentries explaining the jump here. There is going to be another stun. Are they going to find the kill, though? The mana burn will be there. 2017 confirmed the kill, but it looks like the Spectre ult was going to be used maybe to propel that. They didn't expect the rest of the team to be there as well. That's 4 here in the bot again. No, it's not 4 in the bot. One of them canceled. This will be extremely difficult. Now it's 5-1. IX Mike dying yet again to the bot lane, so not exactly preferable. BSJ is actually going in. Okay, yeah, Helm of the Dominator. That's what I thought. Team Freedom having a hard time. 5-1. It's a Shadow Demon Luna lineup, which is just extremely difficult to deal with in general.
A gift from the darkness of battle.
Another disruption is going to be there. The ult coming out by Complete Retard. Eagle staying behind for some reason. They are going to get the totem, however, though. But Nora is here. Double damage to try and confirm some sort of kill. No Searing Chains available. Derp Derp. Thought he was going to die there. Just stood still. Just accepted his fate. He has a haste rune and a double damage. That is something that you do not want to deal with. But another trade, finally, for Freedom. Getting a kill here. Meanwhile, though, BSJ actually 2017 misses both the stun and the basically backstab. BSJ, though, is going the wrong way here. Glimpsing down he's glimpsed back into the static field. A lot of damage going on in him. Derp Derp will end up throwing out the disruption and BSJ to die just to right click. Meanwhile, in the mid, Ifrit diving Jubé, getting that kill as well. That on accident. Eagle back down in the mid here. Doesn't have totem for a defense though. He will end up buying a smoke instead. They want to get something here.
Bottom tower is under attack.
Anyway, Derp Derp. Don't know what exactly this team is like. 50-50 here. 8-2. The wheel is definitely dominating. I'm going to say it's time to switch to the CS in the net worth chart here, but it looks like it is still, again, it's going to be the Razor up on the top of the net worth here. An Ember Spirit kind of under, tied actually with the Luna with the Invisorin now. They want to try and go finally to kill Ifrit here. Some big lag coming out there from BSJ's ultimate. Freedom, though. Are they going to find Ifrit, though? They want to get to the Shrine. The Shrine's not available. Disruption will follow. But it looks like the totem is going down. Derp Derp to fall as well. But meanwhile, in the back line here, it will be a ult going down from the Disruptor. The right click on Nora is going to be there, but not enough damage to follow it up. This is the fight that Team Freedom have been waiting for. 2017 to go down as well. Nora to get a double kill. Now are they going to find Complete Retard? That's the only one left. They end up getting four kills out of that one, and they didn't actually dedicate too much. Actually, there was no lasso even available for Batrider, so that was extremely beneficial for them. So definitely beneficial, 100%.
Tribute to my house.
So that was definitely beneficial now. Ember Spirit now back, or not really back, but on the top of the net worth here at 4-7. And IX Mike, you're going to go for the Force Staff, I believe. No, Drum first, then Blink Dagger. So this is something I've seen every now and again from Batriders, going for Drums instead of Blink Dagger. If they feel their team has the initiation attempts to end up doing that, then so be it. Looks like it will be the five-man push in the mid. They want to claim this Tier 1 tower, and there's no way it's not going down. It looks like it's not really going too well for them. The glimpse is actually going to go back. Jubé not going to be able to fight back for that one. Not even anywhere near the base. Maybe not teleporting directly on top of the tower is the greatest idea. They will let that one slide. Freedom doing okay, but they're not exactly doing the greatest. They got the team fight they wanted just less than a couple minutes ago, and it's definitely great for them. Sentry Ward's going to find BSJ. Sentry Ward's going to find 2017. Enemy's actually going to ult. They have vision of the high ground. They ult preemptively. They're going on Derp Derp here. IX Mike taking... he's going to take a huge chunk of damage here. Silencing Storm, Luna ult, as well as the Spectre ult going down. It looks like it's actually going to be three kills going to Complete Retard. Ember Spirit, though, trying to get another kill. Complete Retard's going to go down. Ifrit, he's going to go down as well from the Ember Spirit. Are they going to find Derp Derp in time? No, they won't. Freedom are actually going to end up getting a two trade off of that. Both the cores for the exchange of the Batrider Spectre and the Undying. So this will be fairly interesting here. Freedom, they're finding their pickoffs they need as quick as possible and as soon as possible. But Boots Travel is going to be the next pickup thing for Nora here. Then everyone's going to rotate back on down. They want to get this tier 1 tower now. Ensure Ward being thrown down just to double check, make sure there's nothing there. They know that BSJ is free farming back up in the top again. Be the Dominator, that is the pickup here. So, tier 1 tower, maybe finally to go down here, it'll be the first tier 1 tower side of Team Freedom here, but Team Freedom, they still have a pretty strong lineup, especially this magic damage, Ember Spirit just being so dirty. It actually deals a lot more damage than a lot of people, a lot of people don't know how much damage the Ember Magic build does. Especially with the 15% spell amplification in the very beginning. Well, it's 25, so that's 40% spell amplification from a continually burning, 60 damage per second, lasts for 20 seconds. So all in all, it's a lot of magic damage. I'm not gonna do the numbers because I don't like math.
Dire's top tower is under
attack. Looks like there might be something here. The Observer Ward's not gonna scout out anybody. It does find Eagle, though the stun's not gonna be there. Disruption to follow. Dying stunned up, really slowed from that creep. It looks like it will be something going on here. IX Mike maybe trying to find the jump on Ifrit here, but no Blink Dagger, no Force Staff. Will be the drums recipe finally coming in, however. Urge Creep's gonna find Mike. The stun's gonna be there. The Spectre ult trying to repel everyone off. Looks like everything's going down here. The totem, I'm getting some weird frame spikes here. So many things going down at once. BSJ is going to end up getting absolutely everything there, sort of. And it looks like Freedom get the kill they want, all the team fight they wanted, and Luna up escaping there. Man, what was with that team? What was that with that frame dropping there? That was something completely on my side. I don't know what that was about. Anyway, it looks like a lot of stuff going on there. I think that's still something Dota needed to fix, was that whole problem there. Because it happens with the Monkey King ult as well. But anyway, we'll worry about that later, because now it's Team Freedom back on the top of the board somewhat, though. The Spectre running at 4-5. If he's coming in Eagle, he is going to end up scouting out Layella. Dust is going to be thrown down as well to try and find IX Mike if he were to go invis. TP interrupted. We're not going to TP up to this top tower. It is gone.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Location going to be expended. Will be actually they want to try and find engaging here. Complete recharge. He's got so much HP. It's actually level 11 and he didn't actually go for anything in the skill tree just yet. Top tower to end up going down. They know that BSJ is coming down to the low ground. 2017 fight sees him. Gonna be the stab in the back here. Not exactly what they're hoping for. Looks like he will actually just escape here. The dominated creep probably not going to escape. Yo, BSJ will leave. Really. As well as the creep. Okay, so no backstab on that creep.
Death and gold are linked.
So early game is going to be, again, still extremely difficult for the side of Team Freedom, but if they can just build up and just stack enough magic damage, end up destroying here. There's the Boots of Travel that's been built up for the Ember Spirit. Looks like a Yule's is the next in the to-do list here for the Ember. So just going for stuff that maybe will deal more magic damage, removal, so on and so forth. Nora, though, he wants to get this rune. He's not going to find it. He does throw a remnant just in case to escape. The glimpse is available, however. Disruptor won't have vision of him for long, especially since he didn't go the way that they are going here. Boots of Travel will be the confirmed leave option. So I guess that means when every single thing goes down during a team fight, I should be ready for some frame skips. Holy moly, that was a lot of frame skips. Anyway, Team Freedom, they're running at 11 and 13 with Ember Spirit on the top of the chart, and now finally the Spectre somewhere on the board. So it looks like the number one way for Wheel to actually counter out damage that comes out from Team Freedom is BKBs, Black King Bar, magic resistance, the pipes. But it's the same thing that Team Freedom would need to counter out the lineup from Wheels as well. So it's like they just wanted to kind of pressure this, but it looks like the lane's finally being pressured as well. going to keep on going in through here. Complete retard. Kind of sacrificing his slow creep here. It's actually going to be a BKB coming out, right? Okay, because every time I see that, it could be something else. Stun not actually going to go out on Batrider. The Spectre ult's going to go down as well as the Totem. The lag! The Silencing Storm is going to be there. It looks like Batrider will be stuck in the backdrop here. Meanwhile, the Lunar ult will go down as well. Nora to end up getting confirmed kills. A lot of damage dealing going on here. Derp will fall as well. That's three kills. Team Freedom finally getting all the kills they needed to end up turning this game around. Team Freedom showing that they have the superior strength, as well as making every single computer possibly skip down to 10 frames per second, because that's basically what that was. So, anyway, like a lot of the people are saying, there is little to no physical damage on the side of Team Freedom with this magic dealing damage from Nora, as well as really just even IX Mike is burned here. He's got no lasso, and he doesn't even have a spec in his tree yet. He's going for all the spells, which he'd much rather do instead. The Courier trying to come in, and will give Nora his Yules. Finally, BSJ. What is he going for here? He's got a blade mail. Bye. Getting low. He might as well just TP. No, he is actually at the shrine, right? Could use up the shrine. No, he is gonna TP back. Team Freedom starting to look pretty good here. They literally, I think this was the plan to bait out that pick Ifrit. He spotted though the slow. Yeah, Dust not gonna be there. Didn't find the Nyx. In fact, Nyx ult was just freshly used. The Aghanim Scepter going to be the next thing on the to-do list. A ward up on this high ground, so it's not going to find anybody just yet. Upon a loyal warrior. We'll figure out what exactly is going to go on here. We can go ahead and talk about items as well as the skill tree builds. We have Derp, who's playing more of the hard support here, so got a lot of wards. Doesn't even have any of the shadow poison. Meanwhile, Luna is going for the... For some reason I was looking at the Dragon Lance and I was gonna say the Force Pike, but that's not what the plan is here. It's going to end up being the Manta style. Looks like actually a lot of people are just not specking into their trees. The Luna not specking into her tree just yet. Disruptor going for 60 gold per minute, has a glimmer cape, and the Razor going in for the Force Pike, and Nyx Assassin, like we said before, going for the Aghanim Scepter. Meanwhile, Undying also playing the hard support here, going for more support based items. Spectre picked up the blade mail, maybe not Radiance, but like maybe Vanguard into some other pure damage item. Abaddon level 11 is gonna end up going into the better version of the gonna end up going into the better version of the amulet. Don't know the name of it yet. Solar Crest. And Batrider, still going for that BKB. He's actually going to switch, going into the Blink Dagger. And Ember Spirit, magic damage, will go for the Blink Dagger himself. So it looks like Freedom, they're having a really good time right now. They're actually doing so much damage with Nora doing these Ember Spirit chains. He's actually going to go for the 6 all stats. I guess I could look at the trees here while we still have some more time. 15 damage has been picked up for the Luna. 60 gold per minute. We've already talked about that. 10 agility on the Razor. Nyx Assassin, 175 health versus spell damage. Undying not yet picked. And 20 damage on the Spectre. 15% experience gain for the Abaddon. Batrider not yet picked either. And the Ember Spirit, 6 all stats, 15 spell amplification. So right now, Team Freedom looking fairly viable at the moment. Eagle, literally every time Eagle does this, I manage to turn to Eagle every time he taunts. Or he's just going to keep on doing it. It's actually one of the better taunts. It's actually definitely one of the better ones. Link Dagger is going to be next on the Batrider to-do list, though. So we are going to see the Batrider engagements going out here. Be fairly interesting to see what goes on here. Invis Rune's gonna be picked up for Eagle. He moves really fast. It's really hard to keep up with him. 15 move speed. He's gonna value the book. Comes out. Actually, it is out.
The rune of regeneration.
Undying. Running around inside their in their jungle right now. And Nora, on the other hand, is gonna end up farming out this top. Coming out really quickly here. But it looks like they are going to try and go and take some sort of fight here. They've been losing almost every single one at 16 and 11. 2017 trying to make a run in here. Eagle is invis. It's a Spectre ult that's going to go down. The glimpse on IX Mike to return him back in. Completely recharged. Throwing down the Luna LT as well. IX Mike will be the first to fall. But meanwhile, BSJ will get Layala. Juve, are they trying to find another engagement here? He will end up throwing out his ultimate here. Nora, he's losing a lot of HP. The Yules is going to be there. The Remnant, though, looks fire at the last second. He will go down as well. That's the Aegis, though. Jubai to go down to a three-man kill there. And it looks like this Ember Spirit not going anywhere. The Blink Dagger actually saves him at the last second. No mana bomb. He turns around the whole entire fight, but looks like he will end up going down still. Killing the Godlike Tree is going to go down here. Ifrit is going to get jumped on by the rest of the team here. Eagle slowed up by that damn creep in the back door here. That is Team Freedom still losing a little bit of that team fight there, but still gaining kind of a good benefit from it though. Did end up losing a few bit of heroes in the very beginning, as well as they losing the Disruptor in the very beginning. But Freedom still benefiting if they get these people out from the kills in the team fights, especially killing the Luna and or Ifrit as well. So this Razor pick, still somewhat beneficial here, removing the damage from the Spectre, but not exactly the worst either. Really hope that's just... Oh, that's on my actual computer. Okay. Anyway, so Shadow Demon finally specced up into his. He's actually in for 6 strength instead of movement speed. Maybe a panic pick. 150 cast range for the Razor, so that means the static link will be even longer. But I don't think this changes at all, since it's not a casting spell. Luna will go for the 40 more Lucent Beam damage, so not any more strength for her. Not really looking forward to dying much easier in the fights. That more Lucent Beam damage. It's good, though. It's good, though. But not exactly the greatest. Nyx Assassin still going for that one, Undying. We already did that one, 90 gold per minute. 6 health stats for the Spectre. The experience gain, Mike is still not specking into his trees. I'm just not going to talk about that.
Double damage.
It's like everyone's all smoked up. They want to try and find engagement. They know they're on the high ground. It will be the bomb going out by Nora, though. He will end up getting the damage. Meanwhile, all this up here is going out. 2017, he is revealed. He will end up trying to burrow to get out. Lunar ult is going to go down. Not going to find anyone. Completely retarded. Will end up falling as well. 4 kills going down. Are they going to find Ifrit, though? The slow is not there. Undying trying to get there, but not going to find it. Still got a tier 1 tower to deal with, boys. That's what exactly they're going to do here. It looks like it's going to be the Lincolns, right? That's what that is? Yeah, Lincolns going to be built up for the Ember. And then afterwards, it'll be the Orchid Malevolence into possibly the, whatever the other thing is called. But they will go down and get this mid tower, the Bloodthorn. That's what it is. And this creeps will end up falling out here. But Team Freedom, another team fight they're benefiting from massively. And the Spectre is finally showing up on the net worth charts here. So, going to be fairly interesting here to see what exactly goes on. The Spectre will end up... They left that tower at, like, no HP. They do get the kill, though. It won't be the jump on Ember Spirit either. They might find one, though. ESJ does get out. Actually, they're going to keep on trying to find one. This isn't really a sort of place that you want to try and find a pickoff here, especially for Team Freedom. Got to grab that rune now, Nora, if you want to get out of there. And that rune will be grabbed. Brian is also available. Looks like the Lincoln Sphere is the next on the to-do list here. They do not find this ward on the high ground here. Does naturally expire, however. But, looks like the pipe was actually built up. Wow, excuse my voice crack. Holy moly. Blade Mail is going to be the instead pickup here for the Razor. He was looking at a Blink Dagger, I think. And then he just realized that he needs to fight back in these fights. So Blade Mail is going to be the next pickup for Ifrit instead. Everyone lining up on the side here. They can get some good kills. They throw down a Sentry Ward. They know that everybody's there. Throw down a Vision Ward. 2017 is going to burrow. They throw down a Vision Ward as well. They know everybody's there. Getting over to the side. They know. Everybody knows it's going to be Disruptor. It's going to be caught out here. Another Spectre ult and a Totem. Huge freaking lag. I don't know why it does this. And everyone's just getting jumped on here. I'm going to... All the illusions, all the Zombos, everything like that. 2017 to fall as well. The Disruption Field isn't going to end up killing out Abaddon here. And completely retarded. Gonna get jumped on here as well. The Disruptor, the only one most likely to escape here. The ult going down from Luna, though, Jubai is actually gonna go down here. BSJ to die as well. Nora to confirm that final team fight there. The only one to survive, as well as the Disruptor on the enemy team, the only one to survive as well. So I gotta figure out why that's doing that weird lagging thing there, but a lot of things to load all at once. So again, I apologize for that. I can't really do anything about that. Anyway, Nora is going to go into the Lincoln Sphere, so just a lot of other items to take up the time here. It'll still be right-click damage with the Mjolnir next on the to-do list from Nora as well. But, Ember Spirit, the only one to survive in that engagement. Still top on the clocks here at 15,000, although the Spectre now at 12,400. The return here instead. Team Freedom starting to look even better at this point. They have a little bit more tower domination as they can push the lanes in much more effectively. Whereas Wheel don't exactly have the best. There's actually even a Gem of Truth site that's up on the Ember Spirit now. 15% cooldown reduction. Not that bad. The Gem of Truth site is in range. He will be able to get that ward up there. So good D ward on that behalf. So the question is Freedom going to be able to take this game and sweep it from under its feet? Or are they going to have to do a real fight here soon? And by real fight, I mean, like, are they going to have to fight like crazy soon? ESJ throwing down his illusions onto the lane. One of the few things that actually deals damage without anyone being there because of that. Oh no, right. The illusions don't have that return ability anymore. So that's fun.
The Rune of Illusion.
It looks like the Roshan is the name of the game here. It's really hard for them to do Roshan, however, as Ember Spirit just doesn't have any physical damage. He went for the magic damage build instead. Yeah, so they understand they can't do the Roshan without the Spectre. The one thing that actually deals damage. But this is definitely great for Team Freedom.
A gift from the temple.
And I think Team Freedom, they understand that they can get a lot of these team fights out. There's like little to no punish from these team fights as well, but the smoke is going to be there. Are they going to find somebody? Nora, he's out in the open. The stun, the smoke's been revealed. Nora's not scared. In fact, they want to turn on this one. Don't manage to get the jump on though. So that will be a disengage there. Freedom, they understand that they are just floating around. Derp Derp D wards. It's gonna be the death of Derp Derp here. Disrupts himself. Will be enough though. He's still taking quite a bit of damage here. Illusions going down and the totem to fall. Maybe not yet. Don't know where that totem is. But it will be the disengage. The Luna caught out by God, why is there a million illusions going out here at once? Will be the zombies that's causing most likely the frame issues here. But it looks like the first to fall will be the Disruptor. And speaking of Disruptor, will be Disruption on BSJ 2017 to get the confirmed kill. Jubai will end up getting sapped out here as well. He's going to lose quite a bit of HP and quite a bit of life. But looks like Nora coming back in. He's like, I'm not done with you yet. Going to end up trying to get on complete retard here. One more right click will do it. Complete retard will fall as well. But it looks like the trade will definitely be a mic here. Nora, though, still hanging around. Maybe trying to get another kill here. He's got a little bit more mana. Blink Dagger, he's got to do it now. Wants to engage, but it looks like he wants to try and fight still. He's gonna meet 2017 though. Blink Dagger, he will be able to get out from that one. So it looks like Ember Spirit, he's on the brink, boys and girls, for that level 25. He's got the cooldown reduction. What is that? The duration is 3 seconds and it's every 6.8 and it counts for 2. So every 3 seconds there's another chain. Or every 3 seconds he can chain again, basically. It's still really strong. The Octarine Core makes it, like, pretty much 0.2 seconds, I think, is the cooldown time. So that is going to be what that is going on here. Go ahead and talk about items now that there's still this somewhat brief time here. I can't tell if the Shadow Demon is going to go for a BKB or something else, but he's got a strength. He's got a strength gauntlet or a strength... like an Ogre Club. It's a strength club, whatever. And looks like he went for the 6 strength. We already talked about that. Luna is, it's got the BKB. It's not really doing too much for him just yet. Disruptor, the Aghanim Scepter to mute the items while inside the ulti there. under attack. And Razor going for the Aghanim Scepter, wants to just deal more damage with that ultimate. Assassin, his item build is not yet revealed. Brian's gonna be popped actually and scouted out by the Luna, so they know that the rest of the team is here. Undying. What is this? The Crimson Guard. Looks like they want to fight here. They're trying to find somebody. Nora doesn't find anybody immediately. I do not know what causes that frame issue. That's really annoying. So they want to stay around this Roshan to make sure there's something going on here, but this no right-click damage on Ember Spirits proving to be extremely difficult here. It's just really hard for Ember Spirit to try and get some of these confirmed kills. So, looks like it's gonna be... wait, what the heck is going on up here? It looks like this whole time, it's the Spectre who got caught out by everybody up in the top. Buyback is available, however, and the illusions are going to be made. I guess it was just so much damage coming in. That's the one thing they were afraid of, so their death will serve. And looks like this Roshan is the next thing on the to-do list here. 2017 to burrow in the background here. Looks like the buyback's gonna be used. The ults are gonna be thrown down. The Luna ult to fall as well. But who will fall first here? Derp Derp to go down. A lot of lag. What is going on? 90 plus illusions on the freaking floor here. And it will be Disruptor who will fall as well. The buyback perfectly timed. Luna to fall as well. 2017 burrowed in the ground. They see him though. He's trying to get out. His death will fall as well. And the only one to escape is Ifrit. And this Roshan definitely just going to go to freedom here. There's no way they can contest this by soaking up this Roshan hits here. But this is probably nearing the end here. The Aegis going to BSJ. Looks like they're just going to go back to farming. It's going to be the Radiance boys and girls coming out on the Spectre. Finally, something that we've all known and love is the typical Radiant Spectre build.
Death tax.
Well, that'll be very interesting to figure out what this game's going to entail, though. A lot of physical damage, so the 18% evasion coming out from the aura itself. Pretty strong. And he's level 22 now, so 15 more attack speed. Go ahead and look at some of the other builds here. It's the 10% magic resistance, 200 more HP for the Razor, or the Disruptor, 250 more HP for the Razor. Assassin went for 10 strength, 300 more HP for the Undying, 25 more attack speed for the Spectre, and it's not percentage, it's attack speed. 5 more armor for the Abaddon, and Batrider finally picking up the skill trees. Gonna go for 4 armor, 175 HP. And Abaddon, we already did that one. Batrider and 15% cooldown reduction. Still level 24, 25 shortly underway, the Mjolnir as well shortly underway. So, IX Mikey is running around with the gem though and 2 TPs. Who's okay, Nora. But it looks like they want this last tier tower here so they can end up cleaning up these shrines. And Nora, they're not gonna do any contesting for it. He even blinks back just in case. But it looks like the Mjolnir is next on the plan here. The Hyperstone may be picked up right now. Oh. Is anyone gonna help Nora here kill the shrine? It looks like they're not gonna try and defend this shrine though. They're really scared though. They don't want to overextend. They're afraid that they're all smoked on top of this shrine, but really they're all bottom right now. There is a ward scouting all of that rotation, so they know they aren't there. And they know they could be waiting for another setup here at this bot shrine. Freedom looking extremely viable right now. The the Spectre though is underneath the Luna still for CS, but the Radiance is actually coming in right now. So this is going to be the scary part with that Radiance running around on BSJ, as well as my computer possibly freaking dying from BSJ popping ult with millions of Radiance illusions burning down my computer ever so slowly. So it'll be very interesting to see if this Radiance will actually do anything. But burn miss is actually 17%, not 18. But it looks like the Radiance is still going to be the lineup here. The Heart will be next on the to-do list here. Meanwhile, for the Ember Spirit, he's got something coming in for himself here. Going to be the recipe for the Mjolnir. So, at this point, the main thing to analyze when it comes to this game is the Disruptor is going to be the main game here. Looks like there's... Oh, okay, so every time that disruption goes off, that's what happens. I'll have to report that in or something, I don't know. Spectre, having a really easy time. On the brink of 25, I'm sure you go for the more health instead of the 10-second spectral cooldown. Oh, 6 seconds, what? Okay, never mind. So 6 seconds, you could throw down the dagger, and the duration is 7, so it's always up. Looks like they are going to end up picking up the now disrupted Nyx Assassin, though. A lot of illusions, a lot of stuff always happening. I hate it when this happens. ESJ trying to go for Derp Derp in the back here, but it looks like that's not going to matter as Nora is going to end up getting kills over here. The Spectre, it will be the Aegis that will be expended here. Ifrit, though, the BKB, he's got a lot of damage stolen. No, he doesn't actually. The Radiant's proving to be super beneficial here. Ifrit, he goes down. The buyback's available. They might have to do it, but this is the buyback from the Luna. The Luna ends up going down as well. Are they going to turn on this BSJ? Still up in the top here. Oh, no. Nora, he's going to end up wailing out on Disruptor here while he's still rooted. The Lincoln Sphere doing its work. Freedom looking really freaking good right now. They're going to get this bot tower, and they're going to get these bot racks at the expense of that buyback coming out from freaking, effing mad, no, from Luna. Come on, there you go. Looks like Ember Spirit trying his best to deal some more magic damage to confirm some extra kill here. They are going to try. The Radiance is the only problem here, as ESJ with that Radiance is going to be a slight issue. Obviously, it's going to be Derp Derp who's going to try and get the benefit of that. Maybe BSJ was building it instead of Nora, which is why the Lincoln Sphere is up on the Ember instead of the instead of that, basically. So the root's going to be there. Ifrit is going to be caught out. Looks like the first to fall will be Derp Derp. They're going to find the next assassin. Invis pile of dirt, not too bad. He's going to end up going down here indefinitely. Spike Carapace trying to confirm something. Everyone was stunned there. Wow. It looks like Ifrit, he is going to try and get away, but it looks like the GG is called, and that's the end here, as Team Freedom will take game number 2 of this best of 3 series, and I believe that means it's over, right? Eagle, he's just standing there, just the, I will soak the tower hits. 22 and 41 at 40 minutes, and Team Freedom to take game number 2 of this best of 3 series. Now, I believe, because of that, that means it is the end, right? Because best of 3, you don't play the third game, so Team Freedom go 2-0 against Wheels. Team Freedom to take the finalizing of that victory. This is Party PD. I believe it's the end of the series since it went for 2-0. And